Sidhu?
Yes, Dadu.
Will you please check if the newspaper has arrived?
Yeah, yeah. Just a minute. What is the world coming to, Dadu? Yet again, people have died in bomb blasts. Our defense and intelligence is collapsing. Being in power is more on the agenda of our leaders than common good. What is happening to the human values of brotherhood, love, and tolerance? Why has individual benefit become more important than collective good?
Such incidents are happening all over the world, Sidhu.
But things don't stop here, Dadaji. You get out on the streets and you see people honking and making way for themselves. No one wants to observe the laws, have self-discipline, or give way to another. No one wants to do an extra inch if they can help it. Girls and boys in school go to the cinema house at 10 a.m. when they should be at school. Look here, Dadu. Babban Bhai has been made the sarpanch of Rampur village despite of his criminal records. Dadu, with such degradation in the quality of our lives, we are heading to our own doom. We have no present or future, and why can't people see that?
Sidhu, you sound like a politician. Come on, sit down. Look, Sidhu, that you are agitated about these things is a good sign. Years ago, Lord Ram was also plagued by the similar thoughts, and he approached the great sage Vasishtha.
Oh, holy sage, please guide me. There is no peace or happiness in mind. As a result, correct action many a time fails. Youth is fading. Company of holy ones is rare. No one is happy at the happiness of others. People are getting baser and baser day by day. Weakness has overcome strength. Good company is hard to come by. I wonder where time is driving humanity. O Holy One, all these leave a mysterious power to destroy even the most powerful leaders. Is there then any hope for a simple person like me? This mysterious power is spreading into one and all and is a major hindrance for becoming successful in life.
Rama, there is no power greater than right action. One should take recourse to self-effort. One should overcome evil by good and fate by persistent effort. Self-effort springs from right understanding, which manifests in one's heart. Self-effort is based on knowledge of the scriptures, instructions of the Guru, and one's own effort. Fate or divine dispensation does not enter here. Hence, one who desires to be successful must divert the impure mind to pure endeavor by persistent efforts.
So, Sidhu, if the world around must change, one has to become part of that change. To achieve success of the righteous goal, one has to work hard and be determined about it.
But is that not the duty of our leaders?
Yes, of course, Sidhu. In our democracy, we have freedom to elect our leaders for different strengths and purposes. In fact, anyone who has attained the age of 18 can cast his vote to elect them. One can choose to become a leader by himself also. So, be a leader by choice, not by chance.
Yes, Dadu, I think I get what you're trying to say. If I want to change some things around me, I will have to be a part of that change. I will have to lead the people to share my vision. I will have to work hard and be the leader.
Very good, Sidhu. You are heading in the right direction. All the best.
Be a leader by choice, not by chance.